Have you ever wondered why a bag of chips is only half full? Believe it or not, it's because of a concept called rancidity. No food items can retain their desirable qualities for an endless period of time. They become spoiled as the result of many chemical actions, including rancidity. When food items containing fats and oils are exposed to air or moisture, they become spoiled. To prevent this spoilage in chips, for example, nitrogen gas is flushed into the chip bags, because nitrogen does not react with fats and oils. As mentioned, rancidity is associated with food containing oil and fatty acids. Fatty acids are composed of fats, cholesterol, and steroids. These are carboxylic acids with a long aliphatic chain. They can be saturated, containing a single linkage between carbon atoms, or unsaturated, with multiple linkages between carbon atoms. Rancidity reactions occur in three steps. The initiation reaction is stimulated by external factors, such as heat and air, which leads to the formation of radicals on the food substance. By definition, a radical is an atom, molecule, or ion that has an unpaired electron. This makes the radical more chemically reactive. During the propagation reaction, oxygen gives rise to peroxides. These peroxides react with more unsaturated fatty acids and produce new radicals. During the termination reaction, two radicals combine and form a new single bond. At the end of this process, fats, oils, and other lipids are decomposed into highly reactive molecules. These are responsible for the unpleasant smell and taste in rancid foods. Rancidity can be classified into two major types, oxidative rancidity and hydrolytic rancidity. A reaction that causes oxygen damage to a food substance is called oxidative rancidity. The natural oil structure is interrupted and damaged by oxygen molecules in a way that changes the food's color, odor, and taste. Oxidative rancidity also leads to the formation of toxic compounds, such as peroxides, that destroy vitamins A and E in foods. Hydrolytic rancidity generally causes an unpleasant odor due to the release of free fatty acids from glycerides. Triglycerides are a combination of three fatty acids generally present in oil foods. When they react with water, they produce glycerol and release free fatty acids that are not suitable for consumption. The factors that affect rancidity include oxygen, the presence of microorganisms, and other physical factors. Exposure to oxygen is the primary cause of rancidity. Oxygen is more soluble in fats, which leads to oxidation and food damage by releasing free radicals. Several microorganisms release an enzyme called lipase, which leads to the hydrolysis of lipids. Finally, factors like temperature, heat, and light play a significant role in rancidification, as they are the major sources for the production of free radicals and accelerate the oxidative process. One of the simplest ways to prevent rancidity is to keep foods away from direct contact with light and air. For this purpose, they can be stored in airtight containers. Adding antioxidants is also an effective way to prevent auto-oxidation action in foods that contain fats and oils. Some of the best natural antioxidants for this purpose include vitamin C, vitamin E, flavonoids, and polyphenols.